Now let's discuss about the operating regions of a transistor and common emitter connections. As we have just now discussed in the previous section while studying input and output characteristics of a transistor under common emitter connections, that a transistor is operated under three possible regions. These are, one by one we can discuss all these regions. Very first one is active region. This is the situation when we say collector junction is reverse biased and emitter junction is forward biased. And you can recall from the beginning we are discussing that under the normal operating conditions of a transistor, its emitter junction is forward biased and its collector junction is reverse biased. And we can say when we are talking about active region, for low values of base current, we can say variation in collector current over the VC, that is a collector emitter voltage, is very small or negligible. Or we can say when base current is small, we can say with variation in collector emitter voltage, collector current is not much affected. And we can say for high values of IB, we can say this variation is large. Or if you just have a look on the output characteristic, once again I can draw just for symbolic purpose, if we draw the output characteristic, that is between collector current and collector emitter voltage. For low values of base current, the variation is very small. But when we move on to high values of IB, you can see the slope of graph increases. Here we can see the value of base current is increasing. So when base current is large, the slope of graph is large, or you can say the variation in IC with variation in VC is more at high values of IB. And for low values of IB, you can see the curve is approximately horizontal. So there won't be much effect on the value of IC if VC is varied. And this is the active region of a transistor under common emitter connections. The second one is saturation region. And saturation region is the one in which we can say when both junctions, that is collector junction as well as emitter junction, are forward biased. So when both junctions are forward biased, we can simply state in this region VC is approximately zero, and we can say small variation in IB does not affect IC. But we can say at higher variations of VC, suddenly the change in IC is significant. We can say this is the zone where we can say for different values of IB also the values of IC are approximately small. But for higher values, suddenly when VC changes, the value of IC also significantly changes. The third one is cutoff region. And this is a situation when we say both junctions are reverse biased. And in cutoff region, we can state obviously when both junctions are reverse biased, the value of IB is zero, and for variation in IC, there won't be effect on IC, but a very small collector current flows due to leakage of charge carriers, that we can also write in this mode. Very small collector current flows due to leakage of charge carriers from emitter to collector. And we can see this is denoted by ICEO, and this is a very small collector current which we generally denote by ICEO. You can just have a look on the output characteristic of this common emitter connection. The previous section I have already drawn and clearly denoted what is ICEO. So this is called leakage current, which flows due to leakage of charge carriers, because in this situation if IB is zero, not much effect of base emitter junction is there, and it is just due to the migration of some of the charge carriers from emitter to collector.